Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 4, lesson number 18, and the topic is fishing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the problem facing fishing in Kenya. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to identify the problems facing fishing in Kenya and their possible solutions. From the diagram, we can be able to get the five major problems our oceans are facing. We have the mercury pollution, that is the pollution. We also have the growing of the coral rocks, which are dying coral rocks. We also have the overfishing, and also we have the industries that are next to the ocean, how they are bringing. And then we have those as the problems. Let us look at these problems. The first problem, it is the environmental limitation. Tropical location of Kenya. Kenya, it is tropically located. Hence, its water bodies are warm. And these will now limit the number and variety of fish in marine fisheries. So that is the first problem. We are facing environmental limitation where we are located. Solution to this one, it is increasing research to get variety of fish species that can survive under these tropical conditions and introduce them in our fishing ground. So we start making studies of the best fish, the fish that do well in warm waters, we put them and in our marine waters. Go to the second one, which is overfishing or overexploitation of the fish resources. This is caused by indiscriminate fishing, over-harvesting of fisheries, use of small meshed nets, sinew, and dowry. It endangers the natural replacement of certain species, since with time the fish species reduce because young fish are not allowed to take time to mature. So there is no that natural breeding. Solution? Prohibiting small meshed gill nets. This is ensuring that the small nets are not used. Then, introduction of fish farming to reduce overdependence on natural fisheries. Another one, it is prohibiting fishing for some time to let the fish regenerate. So, taking time before going to the marine fisheries or natural fisheries, and taking the farming. As you can be able to see, the small gill they are getting, the fish that are too young, too small, that have not even reached to maturity. The third one is pollution. Fisheries, pollution of fisheries by industrial and agricultural waste, sewage disposal and oil spillage make the water less habitat for the plankton's growth and thriving of fish, thus reducing the amount of fish. So what is the solution to this? We have strict registration should be put in place to check disposal of industrial waste into the fishing grounds. Industries are encouraged to treat their water, their waste, before releasing them into the lakes and rivers. Now, as you can be able to see, that is the small fish have started feeding on the plastic. And remember what happens if a dirty feed on the plastic, this plastic are not digested. So it will affect the digestion in the fish. The fourth one, it is the poaching and competition from well-developed fishing nations. Fishermen from Asia and Europe, using advanced equipment and fishing methods, reduce the amount of fish. Also, the fish and sales proceeds land back in their fishing equipment. Solution. The KWS, that is the Kenya Wild Patrol, Services Patrol, the Indian Ocean to monitor and restrict our stray fishermen from Kenya, Kenya waters arrested and confiscated their fishing equipment. That is the only solution to the poaching. Number five, we have the presence of the winds. Some fishing grounds, especially Lake Victoria, is infested with water aikid along the lake shores. This chokes the fishing boats and hinders the fishermen from reaching far areas with a lot of fish. Solution, local community and NGOs, this is the non-governmental organization, and the government should make attempts in removing the winds from the lake. Number six, inadequate capital. Most fishermen in Kenya use traditional methods of fishing that limit their catch due to the lack of adequate capital for purchasing advanced fishing equipment and refrigeration facilities. This limit marine fishing in deep seas with a variety of fish and a lot of catch. Solution, provision of loans to the fishermen through financial institutions and government agencies. This one is done to encourage fishermen. We can also encourage fishermen to organize the cooperative so as to assist them in raising the required capital. Number seven, poor developed transport network. Some roads leading to the fishing grounds are poorly maintained and impassable during the rainy season. This leads to the delay in delivery of the caught fish to the processing plants, factories, and go bad since fish is highly perishable. Solution, the government is making effort to improve the development, to improve and develop the roads leading to the fishing grounds. Number eight, we have the limited market. The demand for fish in the country is small because fish eating is less popular with most communities. Some fishing grounds are located in sparsely populated areas, and fish is more expensive compared to other sources of protein. Solution, the government should encourage the local communities to embrace fish eating as an alternative to red meat throughout, and also they can start establishing the fish farm. Number nine, we have accidents within the lakes and oceans. Sometimes during the year, we have the fish boats and canoes capsize to the lake and in Indian Ocean due to the strong winds and prevailing storms, which result in loss of fishing equipment and even loss of life. The fishermen are therefore prohibited from venturing into far waters with a lot of catch and variety. Solution to this one is fishermen are encouraged to use bigger boats that are motorized, which can withstand the storms and strong winds. This is a point where now they start using the modernized equipment. Number 10, interboundary conflict. Sometimes, Kenyan fishermen are arrested by Uganda and Tanzania authorities for straying into their waters along the boundary of Lake Victoria. They often lose their catch and fishing equipment. Solution to this one, it is the Kenyan policemen to patrol the boundaries to ensure the fishermen remain within the Kenyan waters. They avoid going to other water bodies. Activity for today, citing the solution to the problem, state four problems facing fishing industry in Kenya. For reference, you can get the KRB 2000.